This is the KHKR 45AR. Now, what you are about to witness isn't a regular feature from Boeing or Airbus, and it's not some fancy military prototype fresh out of Lockheed Martin's lab. No, today we are taking you to the heart of Burkina Faso, where the sky is no longer the limit, but more of a mere suggestion. Meet the KHKR 45AR, the aircraft that looks like it was built on a bet, engineered with pocket change, and glued together with hope and courage. At first glance, you'd assume this was an abandoned film prop for a low-budget action movie. But no, this is real. A man who clearly stared conventional aircraft design in the face and said, "Nah, I'll freestyle it." Now let's start with the landing gear, shall we? Forget the rugged shock-absorbing system seen on modern helicopters. The KHKR 45AR boasts four wheels, and not just any wheels, mind you. These babies look like they were snatched off an old supermarket cart, or maybe donated by an abandoned bicycle gang. These wheels are so slim that they could fit between cracks in a runway rather than roll over them. Now let's lift our gaze to the routers, or should we call them windmill wannabes? The top mounted propeller looks suspiciously like it was handcrafted from leftover plastic water tank lids. The kind that would rather flip in the breeze than slice through the air with any authority. The tail rotor shares a similar story, one that feels less aerodynamic engineering and more last-minute science fair project. But wait, the KHKR isn't all exposed frames and experimental design. Oh no, it's got a body. Granted, it looks like a patchwork quilt of iron sheets salvaged from old rooftops, hammered together with enough welding spots to qualify as modern art. The goal? To shield the pilot from, well, probably just some pebble or bird feathers, because one strong gust of wind could likely send this entire structure cartwheeling across the fields. The cockpit window deserves a special round of applause, because from the looks of it, the glass was yanked out of a retired living room window, slapped onto the airframe, and called mission accomplished. You have to admire the commitment to recycling. And stepping inside, it's like hopping onto a time machine set to the late 1800s. The dashboard is an explosion of oversized knobs and buttons, the sort that wouldn't look out of place in a steampunk museum. Green, yellow, red, blinking away as if the helicopter is trying to communicate in Morse code, saying, "Help me, I wasn't ready." But the real heart-pounding detail, the engine. Oh, the engine. Its horsepower rating remains a closely guarded secret, but from the sound of it, we can confidently assume it's hovering somewhere between strong enough to spin the blades and barely able to hold a conversation with gravity. To make things even more thrilling, the engine isn't tucked away in its own cozy compartment like in modern helicopters. No, sir. It's your personal cabin companion, sitting right there beside you, close enough to share stories and occasionally scald your kneecap with heat.
D'abord, j'ai utilisé du fer tor.
Every flight, if it even lifts off, is less of a trip and more of a dice roll against fate. You don't buckle your seatbelt for safety in the KHKR. You do it so that the crash investigators know that you tried. Now picture this. A polished state-of-the-art Airbus H145 with its whisper quiet engines, cutting-edge autopilot systems, and safety certification so long they'd put your FAA terms and conditions to shame. Now put that next to the KHKR 45AR, a machine that proudly skips all those boring regulations and instead offers pure unfiltered adrenaline, raw metal, and in-flight experience, best described as DIY survival training. While a modern helicopter gracefully glides over city skies, the KHKR probably trembles at the sight of a slightly windy afternoon. When commercial pilots run pre-flight diagnostics on touchscreen tablets, the pilot of this helicopter might just knock on the metal with a spanner and wait for the echo to decide if it's safe to fly. So here we are, staring at the KHKR 45AR, the underdog of the skies, the rebel of the runway. Say what you will about its unconventional looks, but there's no denying that passion and ambition hammered into every wobbly rivet. Sure, it might not pass an aviation inspection in, well, any country, but in the heart of Burkina Faso, it stands as proof that human creativity knows no bounds, and neither does bravery. In a world where helicopters are sleek, swift, and sky-ready, the KHKR 45AR is the awkward cousin that shows up to family reunions with mismatched shoes and still manages to steal the show. Will you climb aboard? Probably not. Will you stand by and cheer for the guts behind it? Absolutely. Because while this flying metal puzzle might not make the skies its playground, it's already earned its wings in imagination and fearless African innovation.